क्या हो गया? सुबह से क्लास अटेंड करके थक गए क्या? अरे
नहीं सर, नो सर,
नो में तो बहुत वीकनेस मिल रहा है।
नो सर,
ओके फाइन, कोई इश्यू नहीं, मैं किसी से नहीं बताऊंगा। ओके हम नेक्स्ट टॉपिक कंटिन्यूएशन करेंगे जो लास्ट क्लास का। आज की क्लास में हम ये खत्म करेंगे डिप्थीरिया को। सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद ये क्लास। तब ये मीटिंग खत्म होगा ना, कंटिन्यूएशन के लिए मैं दोबारा एक लिंक शेयर करूंगा, वो लिंक में हम अटेंडेंस देख लेंगे। ओके दैट विल बी फॉर ओनली 10 मिनट्स। समझ आ गया? इसके बाद
यस
मैं दोबारा एक
ओके
और लिंक शेयर करूंगा, उस लिंक के थ्रू आ जाना अटेंडेंस के लिए। ओके वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द क्लास। लास्ट क्लास हमने देखा था डिप्थीरिया मीन्स व्हाट। इफ यू वांट एग्जांपल आई कैन जस्ट गो विद योर ग्लांस। लास्ट क्लास वी सॉ दैट डिप्थीरिया मीन्स व्हाट डेफिनेशन, देन वी सॉ दैट इटियोलॉजी, देन वी मूव ऑन टू द डिटेल्स अबाउट द इटियोलॉजी, देन पैथोजेनेसिस, देन हाउ द आर्च आर वी कैन से दैट फॉसेस फॉर्म। दिस इज द मेन साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स टू आइडेंटिफाई द डिप्थीरिया, दैट इज द ग्रेइश व्हाइट पैलेटाइन लेयर विल बी फॉर्म। द नेक्स्ट टिपिकल प्रेजेंटेशन, अंडर द टिपिकल प्रेजेंटेशन यू कैन एबल टू सी दैट नेसल डिप्थीरिया विच वन आई सेड ऑलरेडी द ग्रेइश व्हाइट कलर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पैच टू आइडेंटिफाई द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स दिस वन। द नेक्स्ट we had moved to the further more morphological characteristics, then staining technique, then cultural characteristics, then toxins, resistance, pathogenicity. So we get till here. Then after that we are continuation with the pathogenicity, particularly in the form of signs and symptoms according to the system wise. Okay, so here I had just quoted some example like nasopharyngeal diphtheria, that means pharynx and larynx, what will be the signs and symptoms. Then after that cutaneous level, then after that systematic complications. Okay, so over that if you are seeing the clinical features, for commonly we can able to identify the individual will have malaise, sore throat, fever, then the individual will have adherent gray pseudo membrane, that is the classical signs and symptoms. The pseudo membrane is the grayish white near to the arch we can able to identify. Then after that nasal ulcers, then after that obstruction of larynx and lower airway due to inflammation and thickness of the secretions. Okay, then difficult in swallowing, then leads to myocarditis, that is to systematic from the respiratory tract. Next it is entering into the circulation, then entering into the myocardial layers, that is myocarditis, infection and inflammation of the myocardium. The next peripheral neuritis, where it is entering into the peripheral layer of the neurons, infection and inflammation of the neurons. Then paralysis of limbs, this will takes place. So first common signs and symptoms, if you are seeing malaise is present, that is we can able to say that it's a fatigue, or we can say that feeling like illness. The individual will have completely general body discomfort. The complete general body discomfort only we used to say it as malaise. Then sore throat, fever, then adherent gray pseudo membrane, that is the classical signs and symptoms of diphtheria near to the both the palatine arch. You can able to see at the side of the cheek there some whitish gray appearance and swelling will be present. Then nasal ulcers, then obstruction of larynx and lower airway, difficulty in swallowing. Then after this, from the respiratory tract the infection furthermore spread to the next level. From the circulation, it entered into the circulation. From the circulation, it goes to the myocarditis, then peripheral neuritis, then paralysis of the limbs. These are some of the common one which is present, or the severity, how the severity is spreading over. So over this clinical signs and symptoms, or we can say the clinical features, first we will see that incubation period. That means once it is entering inside the mouth, then the colonization has been formed. After the colony is formed, they start to get proliferate. So it takes 2 to 5 days with a range of 1 to 10 days. That means in maximum cases, you can able to see that at an average 2 to 5 days, the signs and symptoms will start, or clinical features will start. Okay, but maximum cases, if you are taking majority of the cases, if you are taking, some members are having first day and maximum till 10 days. So as a range, we are having 1 to 10 days. Okay, so what will be happen here? First thing is, once it enter inside, it first involves, it may involves mucous membrane. The next, classified based on site of infection, where it is taking place. Example, if you are saying, you can able to see that the site of infection may be a anterior nasal. From the nasal, from the nose, it may extend to the pharyngeal and tonsil areas, that is tonsillar. Then after that, it will enter into the laryngeal layer. After laryngeal, it will enter into the cutaneous. After the cutaneous, it enter into the ocular. From the ocular, then you can able to see that via the circulation and other form, it will reach to the genital. Or you can say that these are the classification based on the site of infection. Either it may enter into the nose. Yes, mute yourself. Either it may enter into the pharynx or tonsil or larynx or cutaneous or ocular or genital region. Okay, so these are the site of infection. So you can able to see that this is the classical signs and symptoms. I'll show you. This area is the classical signs and symptoms. You can able to see that the child mouth here, the grayish layer is present. Here the grayish layer is present, grayish white. This is pseudomembrane, where infection and inflammation of the arch, near to the arch, you can able to clearly see. Okay, then the next one is, you can able to see that the individual is having classical signs and symptoms. A 10-year-old boy with severe diphtheria. What the individual is having? The individual is having conjunctivitis. That means you can able to see that the conjunctiva is infected. So reddish color of the conjunctivitis you can able to identify. The next one is the pharyngeal membrane, which has been affected, the pharynx. So it will be present from over here, then the nose and mouth connected area. So this will be present, these areas, the pharyngeal membrane will be affected. Then bull neck, you can able to see here, the neck was enlarged, resembling like a bull neck. Then severe myocarditis. Here, once the individual was infected, then the vaccine will not work properly. So they had given here, all the vaccines are contraindicated. So that means once the infection enter inside the nose or to the mouth, the tonsil area has been infected. After that, you can able to see that here the boy got the site of, the 10-year boy got the site of infection is conjunctiva, that is the ocular region. From the ocular region, furthermore, it enter into the pharynx. Then from the pharynx, then the neck has been affected. After the neck, it enter into the muscular layer of the heart. It has been enter inside. Okay, then after that, you can able to see that once again, this is the real case, how the classical signs and symptoms will be looks like. We can able to see that how this area will looks like. I will mark. You can see here this particular one, how it looks, and this one, how it looks, where these both are the main classical one. You can able to See, this is called the grayish white pseudo membrane. Grayish white pseudo membrane. Here also you can able to see this one clearly. Okay, so this is at the side of the cheek, near to the arch. Then after that, the next, this is at the site of cutaneous layer, at the site of infection, skin lesions. So here it present like this. You can able to see this one clearly. It present like this. Then you can able to see here rashes like formation with a whitish secretions. This is also you can able to see. This is at the side, we can able to say that outside the neck, anterior portions, then side, lateral positions of the neck and cheek. Then next, we are moving to the fowcial diphtheria, very common. That is what we had saw the classical signs and symptoms of pseudomembrane. The next, malignant or hypertoxic toxemia, marked adenitis, then circulatory failure. This you can able to see. That is malignant means there is a formation, unusual formation of excess amount of, we can able to say that accumulation of dead cells. Okay, accumulation of dead cells that will be present. We can able to say that in the form of it's a fatal issues that will leads to formation of we can able to say that that means if a particular cell which is not functioning properly or the particular cell has been died, which indicates which is a threat for our body, where that we can able to say that like carcinogen, we can able to see that malignant in that cancer form of cell formation, that is the cells died there, due to that that will become a toxic to the own body itself. Okay, the next, the same cell where it is present near to the cell also will be considered as the same, where possibility are there our own immune system start to destroy our own cells. The next, paralytic sequelae will be present. Paralytic sequelae means like paralysis, like sequence will be present. Sometimes the child may have the paralysis of the lower extremity. Sometimes it may present at the upper extremity. Okay, it's vice versa, depends on the severity of the condition. Then two septic ulceration cellulitis, then gangrene and epistasis bleeding tendency. Two septic ulcerative cellulitis, like example, this is ulcerative cellulitis. Once the individual got the infection, after the infection, you can see that once the individual got the infection, after the infection in this area, there will be a small blister like formation. After the blister like formation, the individual doesn't take care of this one properly. Then the blister will ooze out. That means it will get blast out and the secretions will come out. After the secretion, once again, the infection and inflammation will start to, you can say that, will start to enlarge. Like at the beginning, it was only this much size. Then later on, further stage, this was enlarging to this much bigger size. Then furthermore, this will become cellulitis. Cellulitis means the cells are completely infected and it went deep inside. After deep inside, what will happen? This whole area was entirely become, pus collections will be present and it will be oozing out, and the surrounding nearby cells also start to get affected, and which shows the resemblance of enlargement of the infection and inflammation. This will be present. Okay, so this is main problem that will leads to gangrene formation, where the cells, furthermore, the functions or the signals will not be carried forward to the preceding cells. That will become a problematic. The next we are having the epistasis bleeding like tendency. Epistasis is the nose bleeding due to excess heat also, or due to nose plug we used to have bleeding. Same like that. Here they used to have epistasis tendency like bleeding, like running nose like. Along with that, we'll have the secretions or blood will be oozing out and coming out due to the damage of the cell walls. The next complications, if you are seeing, asphyxia causing mechanical obstruction. So due to that, exchange of the gases will be difficult and the individual is having the breathing difficulty. Exchange of oxygen will be less. So that may lead to breathing difficulty or breathing problem. That may leads to a problem of sometimes the individual may go for unconsciousness or some other problem. The next may need tracheostomy to make the individual to get that means exchange of the air to get properly. The next, circulatory failure due to the lack of oxygen supply or breathing, automatically the circulation will get collapse because oxygen supply is not present. The next, post diphtheria paralysis of the individual, either extremities only, either extremities only or some other areas like hemiplegia or paraplegia or quadriplegia. That means either both the four extremities are paralyzed, or half of the body was paralyzed, or upper portion of the body is paralyzed. Like that, it can present. Then non-toxinogenic clinical manifestation. Other than this, bacteria can produce endocarditis, infection and inflammation of the endocardial layer. The next, meningitis, infection and inflammation of the meningeal layer of CNS. The next, cerebral abscess formation, that is pus collection formation in the cerebral area. Then osteoarthritis, that is mainly the individual will be having arthritis problem. Mainly the individual will be having arthritis problem, or we can able to see that this osteoarthritis more commonly we'll see in the old age, but here the children used to suffer with the same problem. What are the thing will be that this osteoarthritis, it will affect the infection and inflammation of the joints. One, along with the joints, there will be a severe pain and stiffness. Then you can able to see that furthermore, this will, we can say that degenerate to the nearby layers like cartilages and synovial membranes. So this will become furthermore a serious issue for the child. So you can able to see here the complete formation of the disease, how this was formed. So here you can able to see that the disease, first one is entry by the nose. Okay. Second, this is spreading the bacteria entirely. Anjali, audio mute karo. Okay, so yahan par dekh lo, the first entry, microorganism first enter ho raha nose mein. Then after that, you can able to see that from the nose, point of the nose, it is started to enter via the respiratory tract. From the respiratory, these black dots and all. From the respiratory tract, furthermore, this is entering into the circulation. How? From the upper respiratory tract, it goes to the lower respiratory tract to the lungs. Lower respiratory tract to the lungs. From the lungs, this will enter into the pulmonary artery. From the pulmonary artery, it will enter to the heart. So once This is entering into the heart. The second one is spread of the bacteria rarely become disseminated, but toxin becomes blood-borne. So from the respiratory tract, it entered the circulation has become blood-borne toxins. From here, the third one, the disease start to enter into all the areas and start to produce the disease. From where and all? Pharyngeal diphtheria, pharyngitis will be present. Then hypoxia due to the pseudomembrane obstruction. That is difficulty in breathing or lack of oxygen. Then along with that, the individual will have fever. Then lymphadenitis, that is infection of the inflammation of the lymph nodes as well as the adrenal glands. Then cutaneous diphtheria, that is over the spleen lesions. Then systematic complication already we have saw. Then toxic peripheral neuropathy, toxic myocarditis and congestive heart failure. Okay, then the last, the portal of exit is either by the nose or by the mouth. Same, the entry and exit by the same way, but between that entry and exit, this many activity will take place. Okay, once again I repeat, the entry and exit via the nose or by the mouth, entry. From there, it start to affect the upper respiratory tract. Then from the upper respiratory tract, it enter into the lower respiratory tract. You can able to see. I will change this side. Lower respiratory tract. Okay. So example, you can see that bronchi and alveoli. Then you can see that lungs. Okay. Then from there, this will enter into the circulation. From there, where it is entering? It is entering into the circulation, this point. 1 minute. From there, it enter into the circulation, this point. Then after the circulation, what are the infection, or we can able to see that from there onward, the signs and symptoms will start to erupt out. The signs and symptoms start to erupt out in this form. Pharyngeal diphtheria, that is pharyngitis. Then hypoxia, then fever, then lymphadenitis, then cutaneous diphtheria. Then after this everything has been affected, then this will go back to the exit. So that means it has maximum affected the individual, including the complications. What are the complications? Like systematic complications will be present. That is toxic peripheral neuropathy, toxic myocarditis, then congestive heart failure. Okay, so after all this has been completed, then the disease exit from the individual body and start to spread to other members. Then next, this will be the cutaneous infection. So these are the classical signs and symptoms, or you can say that pathogenicity completely completes. Then furthermore, we are moving to the laboratory diagnosis. Laboratory diagnosis, if you are seeing, specific treatment is more important than laboratory diagnosis. So even though with the help of the classical signs and symptoms, we can able to confirm the disease condition, but we need to identify what kind of toxin, according to the three type of toxin, which toxin is present. Then we can able to say that how severity the disease condition is present. So for that, what you want to do? Isolation of the diphtheria bacilli, then testing for toxic genicity. Okay, so how we can able to take? We can able to take that collection of specimen or throat swabs, then smear examinations, we can able to take. So by taking these two, we can able to go for Gram staining or Albert's Pondus staining. Then after that, we can able to go for immunofluorescence method, where the culture on lupus serum slope and telluride blood agar or blood agar. With this one, you can able to confirm, yes, there is Mycobacterium diphtheria is present. Sorry, Cornibacterium diphtheria is present. Okay, so what are the sample they have took? We can able to take the specimen or we can able to take throat swab, we can able to take smear examination. By taking these two with the help of Gram staining and Albert's Pondus staining, we can able to identify the microorganism is present. Then after that, we can able to do that immunofluorescent methods. Okay, the next here, the culture on Lufla's serum slope and Telitrum, Telitrate blade agar and blade agar, we can able to do. Okay, the smear sample or the secretion, the pus collections are there. The pus we can able to take to identify the sample, to identify the microorganism. Okay, so this is throat swab, how we can able to take with the help of the tongue depressor. Directly we can able to place the tongue depressor like instrument will be present. We directly we can able to place under the throat and we can able to take that one and we can send for the laboratory test. The next, isolation of Cornibacterium diphtheria. We are taking serum slope growth in 6 to 8 hours. We can able to identify. Then stain with Neisseria's stain, Albert's stain. Then bacilli have metachromatic granules that we can able to identify under the microscope. Then Telitrate blade agar takes 2 days for manifestation of polymers. Okay, so what are the things they are identifying? Here they are identifying. Here they are identifying with the help of the serum slope. That is the pus example. You can take that the pus collection we have took. The pus collection we have took. Here the growth in 6 to 8 hours. Then after that they are taking Albert staining one to identify the microorganism. Then after that, with the help of under the microscope, you can able to see that metachromatic granules. That is both the end, there will be dot-like circle formation will be present at the head end and the tail end. Then after that, in Telitrate blade agar, you can able to identify that within 2 days, you can able to identify that colony formation. Colony formation you can able to identify. Then next, virulence test. So this is another one important. We want to identify that what are the virulence test is present. That is the toxic level will be present. So in vivo and in vitro. In vivo, in animal, subcutaneous test, inject broth from culture into 2 guinea pig, 0.8 ml. One animal given 500 units of antitoxin, other no vaccine. Animal not given antitoxin will die. Loss of animal restricts this test. So that means in this test, they had identified that for the which animal they had given that antitoxin dose, that animal was survived. The which animal they didn't give, that animal was died. The same thing we can able to see that in human also, it may present the infection where the individual was affected, the individual having the possibility of death. So if the individual was vaccinated, the individual can able to be survive and the individual was not having the infection. If having the infection also not that much severe. So intracutaneous method they had used. One animal given 500 units before toxin, other 50 units after toxin. So the animals can be saved. So that means that they had identified two methods. One is 500 unit before toxin. That means before any infection, then 50 units after the infection. So in vitro testing where Elix gel precipitation test has been used. Here the individual has used that impregnated with diphtheria antitoxin 1000 units per ml. This is for information only. Tested on the horse serum agar, then positive or negative or test training tested for immunodiffusions. So line of precipitation test positive. Other method testing is tissue culture. So this person has been identified how to do the test as well as after doing the test, what the next furthermore action has to be taken place. Okay. The next here uses sick test, but which is outdated right now. They are not using this one. This sick test is used It is an intradermal test. The test is carried out by injecting intradermally into the skin of the forearm 0.2 ml of diphtheria toxin, while into the opposite arm is injected as a control, the same amount of toxin which has been inactivated by heat. But the individuals are those who are infected with this one more interruptedly. So this has been asked nowadays using. The next, you can able to see that negative reaction interpretation. The negative reaction, if a person had immunity to diphtheria, no reaction will be observed. Positive reaction, an area of induration 10 to 15 mm in diameter generally used to appear within 24 to 36 hours, within 1 to 2 days. The size will increase. Then maximum development by 4 to 7 days. The control of harm shows no changes. The person is susceptible to diphtheria. False positive, which is going to show that there is some allergic reaction, but not the positive signs of diphtheria. Then combined reactions, both false also will be present as well as the positive reaction also will be present. Then this one is taking risk on the children, and this will possibility of that for the immunity affection also. So this test was a risky one, so they are not following this one. Then epidemiology, eradicated in developed nations, then children between 2 to 5 years are more commonly affected, and asymptomatic carriers are more, then person to person easily it will spread, then carrier spread this one more easily, then prolonged contact. Same right now, same like our COVID only, these are easy for us to understand. Okay, right now it is not eradicated. Yeah, as per the COVID, if you are taking the epidemiology, is not eradicated in all the nations, but it is carried between maximum age group, all the age groups are affected. Then symptomatic also present, asymptomatic also present. So here in the diphtheria, if you are seeing, this was eradicated in developed countries like America, UK and all. Then children between 2 to 5 years are more commonly infected. Then asymptomatic carriers are more common. Then person to person contact is more easily it will spread via person to person. Then carrier easily used to spread the infection without any signs and symptoms, then prolonged contact is needed for the spread. Then prophylaxis, we can able to prevent this one by proper immunization. The immunization is in two form, active and passive. Then both passive and active we can able to use, or third immunity also they will produce, and sick test, then immunization with antitoxins. Active immunization of toxoid, toxin treated with formaldehyde, then absorbed toxoid, then given by intramuscular route, given in DPT or DTP, triple vaccines will be given. Then primary immunization, 3 doses of DPT at least 1 month interval or 4 weeks interval. Like example, at the beginning, 6 weeks, the first 2 dose of DPT will be given. That is 1.5 month. 1.5 month child. Then from there, 1 month interval, 2.5 month, then 1 month interval, 3.5 month, 3 doses will be given. Okay. So after that, then the doses will be divided into furthermore. Furthermore, that dose will be divided into DT, diphtheria and tetanus. DT, diphtheria and tetanus. Then after that. Okay. So mainly the vaccinations are given for the child to produce the regular, we can say that immunity for the diphtheria, so that we will prevent that disease spreading to the individual or the severity of the disease conditions. Okay, so we can able to see that there will be 3 doses for the children. Okay, within 4 months. Then after that, booster dose are given for the children within the age group of 3 to 5 years in the form of DT. The next, passive immunization, given in acute infection, then give subcutaneously, then 500 to 1000 units of antitoxin, then given as horse serum, then combined in acute infection. That is, passive immunization will be given for the individual, those who are infected. After that, they are giving passive immunization. But this is very rare one. Nowadays, this infection were not present, very less or more commonly, because if vaccination is more actively participated in all the places, so where the diphtheria disease condition reporting was very less. They are moving to the eradication process. The next treatment, antibiotic, not usually.
Yes.
Adarsh, apna वॉल्यूम म्यूट करो. एंटीबायोटिक नॉट यूजफुल इन अक्यूट इन्फेक्शन एंड एंटीटॉक्सिन्स ए मस्ट. देन एंटीटॉक्सिन्स ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम हॉर्स सीरम. Then mild 20,000 to 40,000. Then moderate 40,000 to 60,000. Severe 80,000 to 1 lakh will be identified. Then commonly used antibiotics are penicillin and oral erythromycin. Okay, so this penicillin and oral erythromycins are more commonly used. But maximum we can able to see that we are trying to prevent this disease condition instead of treating. So nowadays the treatment as well as the prevention are more effectively working, because the vaccine drive was more effectively working in all the countries and maximum children are vaccinated where these conditions were not reported. Okay, so this is about diphtheria. You can connect once again for the attendance. I will share the link.